Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. I am Dr. Jyoti Aradas. Today we'll talk in detail about a crucial first step if you are suffering with allergies or getting treatment, especially for allergic rhinitis. It is very important to confirm whether your symptoms are actually due to allergies or not. Many symptoms are common to both allergic and non-allergic rhinitis, like headache, facial pressure, throat clearing, post-nasal discharges, etc. Both allergic and non-allergic rhinitis presents with chronic symptoms, that is, symptoms that has been there for a longer period of time. Among this, 95% of the patients presents with continuous and early morning sneezing. That is sneezing that is coming in the morning time immediately when the person is getting up. That is 10 to 12 attacks at a time with profuse nasal discharges. So persistence of these two symptoms eventually leads to partial or complete nose block. And among this non-allergic rhinitis, there are different types like drug-induced rhinitis, which we usually see in patients who are taking antihypertensive drugs, those who take drug for erectile dysfunctions, those who are on psychiatric medications, etc. Overuse of nasal decongestants also cause these type of rhinitis. Another type of rhinitis is hormone-induced rhinitis, which we usually see in women during their pregnancy period when the estrogen and progesterone levels are elevated. The next type is vasomotor rhinitis, which is the most common among the non-allergic rhinitis. In this, triggers are present. It can be tobacco smoke, perfumes, or any other environmental factors. This usually confuses the patient to understand whether it's a trigger or an allergen. So, for a better understanding, seeking medical help will be apt in this situation. The next is geriatric rhinitis, which is also known as senile rhinitis or atrophic rhinitis. In this, chronic inflammation to the inner membrane of the nose, that is the nasal mucosa, leads to dryness, crusting, nose bleeding, complete loss of smell, post-nasal discharges, that is dripping of the fluid into the throat, as a result constant coughing, throat clearing, etc. This type of rhinitis is usually seen in adults above the age of 60 years. The next type is gustatory rhinitis. This is seen in persons when they eat a certain kind of food like hot and spicy food. Here, the allergic rhinitis, right, like sneezing and nasal congestion are being present without any allergic reactions. So differentiating among all these type of rhinitis is very important in determining the treatment and medication. Wrong medication due to any misunderstanding always leads to poor results. So after finding out whether your symptoms are due to allergic or non-allergic causes, the next step is to have a correct understanding and getting appropriate treatment for your allergic rhinitis, the details about which I'll be talking in my next video. If you have any doubts related to this topic, you can ask me in the comment section. Thank you all for listening. Be informed and stay healthy.